Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Miami Yacht Show here in beautiful Miami. I'm Kelly.
I'm Amanda. We're here with the latest episode of From the Helm.
And we're here with Patrick Sciacca with Yachting Magazine. So good to see you, Patrick.
How you doing? Nice to see you guys, man. Welcome.
Thank you for joining us.
Yeah, so the show's kicking off not too long from now, and it's a new location, new year, so we're excited here.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And we are at the Galeon booth here at the MarineMax, or the Miami Yacht Show, and be sure to check us out all weekend long. And if you guys have any questions throughout this live stream, or if you have questions afterwards, or even throughout the entire weekend, we're going to be here answering questions for you guys, so be sure to ask your questions and give us a shout out if you see us at the show.
Plus, when you ask questions, make comments, we like to send you free stuff.
Yeah, so, we're really into sending free stuff. So
you're like, wait, let me go make a comment.
Give me free stuff.
So Patrick, let's start off with your background. How did you get into boating, and why do you love boating?
I think probably like most people do, I was fortunate that my father had the bug early. And
sure.
he came up, he was a kid from Brooklyn, moved out to the suburbs and saw the ocean for the first time, fell in love with it.
Okay.
And when I was like two, he bought his first boat and he raised our whole family on it. So, mm-hmm. you know, like a lot of people, I just grew up on the water and it really got into me, and both, you know, my whole family's still boating. You know, mm-hmm. my brother and I both became captains. So I got to thank my father a lot, actually, because he's the one who got us started, and it just took.
I do hear that a lot. Is it generational thing, right? Mm-hmm. You know, the dad passes it on to their son, that son passes it on. It's a bug that gets in you and doesn't leave, right?
Yeah, and then when you find that you can actually make a living, you know, in boats. I mean,
best of both worlds.
It is the best of both worlds.
Yep. You know? So was it very intentional to go into journalism with...
So accidental.
Yes.
No, it was
really?
So accidental. Yeah, no, it totally happened by mistake. I actually, there was used, this is going back 100 years in the internet world, but this thing called monster.com showed up in the late 90s, right?
Yeah.
That's big.
So I was working in trade press, and so I saw this ad for an editor for a boating magazine. I was like, wait,
is this possible?
That's a job? So, you know, and I was able to attach all my files. Mm-hmm. And so that was like a big deal to the editor-in-chief over there. And so he hired me off of that because I could figure out how to use the internet.
Oh. Because
this was the 90s.
Yes.
And it was so new.
The up-and-coming technology.
Yeah, I mean, the magazines didn't even have websites at the time. So the fact he's like, he brought me in and he just interviewed me for like 15 minutes and he hired me.
Mm-hmm.
And I was still typing two fingers at the time too, so which was really odd. But then I found out. Yeah, and I said. Well, what's the job? And he's like, well, you're gonna test boats. I said, that's a job.
Wow.
And so here we are. This is my 19th year.
And now.
19.
So you've tested a few boats. That's what you're saying.
About 300.
Yeah. Wow.
About 300.
And now editor in chief of Yachting Magazine. So tell us a little bit about that. What goes into being the editor in chief of a magazine like Yachting Magazine?
Man, well, it's changed for sure. When I first started, it was a print magazine. Magazine every 30 days.
Sure.
Now we're a print magazine. We're a website. We're, you know, a social media influencer. We are, you know, we have all these brand extensions, you know, events and whatnot. So it's managing all of the content for all those different channels, which is the job has definitely evolved over the years.
Mm-hmm.
So when we're here, it used to be to see what's new and kind of get a handle on what, looking forward, what we're going to test, what we're going to, you know, be looking as far as issue themes and whatnot. And now it's doing stuff like this, you know, bringing people the information and the yachts live from the show,
mm-hmm.
and then producing content throughout the show, and then going back and, you know, taking the videos and uploading those, making sure that's all happening, and then as well planning for the future issues of the magazine. So
sure.
you can see it's a lot more. It's
the job like tripled.
Yeah,
it is tripled. Yeah, but it's exciting. It's exciting because mm-hmm. there's, you know. If you just look at the print magazine, which is 80-something thousand subscribers a month,
mm-hmm.
you know, with the social audience we now have, which numbers close to 293,506, just guessing.
Ooh. Yep.
You know,
pretty
that's
close,
all.
I'm sure.
Yeah, it's pretty close. We have so many more people we can reach now,
mm-hmm.
and that's a very exciting thing for somebody who produces content.
Yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm. We're reaching our readers, but we're reaching a whole new audience as well across the world.
And what do you think your readers are looking to you guys for? Like, what is it that they're like, yes, Yachting Magazine is my go-to source for?
Well, we consider ourselves inspirational.
Mm-hmm.
So say we have that guy that has, you know, we're on a 65 footer, right,
mm-hmm.
today. So maybe there's a guy out there who has a 50 footer,
mm-hmm.
and he's thinking about what his next boat is going to
mm-hmm.
be.
Mm-hmm.
So we want to, you know, we want to definitely talk about where he's at, but we also want to talk about where he's going to go.
Sure.
Yeah.
You know, and kind of help him, you know, get the, you know, find out what that experience is like of moving up to that next level of yacht. What are the things he can do with it once he gets there? You know, maybe he was a local cruiser, but maybe he now wants to expand his horizons to do the Great Loop. So we want to make sure we're doing stories like that that kind of inspire people to not just buy a product, but then use it and live the lifestyle. Because we really want to, you know, it just constantly remind people, you bought this thing, use it. Spend time on the water.
Well, I think that's where we are pretty similar because with MarineMax, you know, we're all about the getaways and getting people to use their boat. You did mention, I mean, yeah, coming from a magazine to now where it's basically you can go live and people can tune in. That kind of technology, a lot of people in the past, it used to be kind of a younger generational thing to get into that kind of technology. But now we're seeing that people of all ages are into just watching a live video of us talking about boating, right?
Hey, when I saw my father FaceTime my son, I knew something had changed in the world.
Sure.
You know, I mean, when the grandparents are now using the technology, you know.
Using emojis, too?
Yeah.
You don't even need letters anymore. You just get
thumbs up and smiley faces. But using the technology, to connect with the audience and share, and it gets people really excited.
Yeah.
You know, and that's what we want to do. We want to get people excited and enthusiastic about what it is, you know. We had a motto at our company, which is empowering enthusiasts to do what they love, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of our, like, overall theme driving. So that's, you know, there's so many ways we can do that now. So many ways. So it's very cool. And it can be... It can keep you busy.
Yeah, because you always have to kind of keep up with the trends, right? I mean, things change rather quickly in this world now.
Absolutely. And then you can also most people don't think about viral moments in yachts, but they happen.
Yeah.
Because there are so many enthusiasts out there, and when you show them something super cool, you know, like the first time we showed a stabilizer working, you know, and there were 3 million views within 5 days.
It's just
like, so the passion is out there.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just finding all those places to connect with them.
Yeah, we recently did the video with an engine room and an azimuth, and it just.
I mean, people want to see things that they don't see every day, right? I mean, they want to see just from our perspective, being in the service center and just seeing a forklift bringing a boat over into a different location or into the water is a big deal for some.
Yeah, and the aspirational side, I was over in Italy last April, and I was actually on an azimuth 55 off Savona.
Okay.
And we were just cruising, and it was kind of great, like the Sunshine State. It was a great day like this, but the water was beautiful. It was a beautiful, like, turquoise. So while we were running down the coast, I went down because it has this full beam master with these hull side windows. And so I just took a little 10-second frame of that, what the view is if you're in the master cruising in Savona, Italy on this boat, and put it on Instagram. And within the first day, it was 60,000 people had watched, you know. And it's like, that's what we can do in 2019 that you can't always do 15, 20, even 8 years ago.
And the 60,000 people 10 years ago would never have seen that ever, you know, unless they happen to come.
And if any of them get on that boat at a show, they're going to go right down to that stateroom.
Yeah. They're like, well, at a show, we're looking at the dock space or something, but where could this take us?
Yeah, you put it in context.
And that's what boating is all about, right? I mean, it's where can you go and where can you just enjoy yourself with your friends, family?
Absolutely. It's time on the water. Yeah.
So you were mentioning the print magazine earlier as well.
Mm-hmm.
We have currently out is the March issue and then coming is the April.
Coming is April.
What's, you know, being talked about?
Well, we do 12 themed issues a year.
Mm-hmm.
So March we just finished up is electronics.
Mm-hmm.
So... But instead of just being straight up like product discussions, we also look at the people behind the technology, and you know, we look at, you know, the people who are innovators. Like in this particular issue, we did an extensive feature with Giuseppe Carnevali, without whom there would not be electronic cartography.
Mm-hmm.
And there isn't a person who's watching right now that doesn't have a chart on that they can go press and go and go to the next waypoint. Well, that's all Giuseppe and his company that he founded 30 something years ago. So we do stories like that as well, so people also understand where it comes from, you know, and also get a chance to speak to a great mind like that to see where it's going to go.
Sure.
That's really cool.
Yeah, visionary and somewhere, you know, some people that can tell you about the technology and learning about what it takes to get people to that state.
And also, it's really interesting if you see that particular issue because he came to that moment by watching a James Bond film. He was watching James Bond.
Was it Thunderball?
He was trying to. Yeah, he was using his car to locate the guy. You know, I think it was Goldfinger.
Yeah.
And,
yep.
And he saw it on. And he saw this thing on the screen on the TV with Bond. And he went, "Wouldn't it be great if we could manage boats this way?"
Sure.
And then he just figured out how to do it.
Yeah.
Inspiration.
Was a Bond film. Yeah. Now we have electronic cartography on this boat, on every boat here.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
You know, which is amazing.
And again, for all the people tuning in, if you guys have any questions, be sure to ask us. We'll be here at the Miami Yachts Show and the Miami Boat Show all weekend long.
Mm-hmm.
Check out all the latest models that we have at the show here. And
And it's a reminder, the Miami Yacht Show is at its new location in downtown Miami this year. Don't go to Collins Avenue.
Do not go to Collins.
You won't find us. You won't find Patrick. You won't find any boats. It'll be really not fun.
Yeah, so check us out. So tell us about the boat show here. Miami Yacht Show, Miami Boat Show. I mean, what's new this year? What's changed with this?
Oh, my gosh. Well, you know, we started seeing this thing, this trend starting last year with the emergence of the Super Center Console, right? Mm-hmm. So, I mean, the center consoles have been growing in size, you know, season after season. And now it's just, you know, if you would have told me 5 years ago there was going to be a 65-foot center console, and now Scout has the new, you know, 53-foot center console, you know, I would have said there's no way that that was possible. But the engine technology has made it possible. So seeing the advancements in the outboard technology that is allowing these boats to grow in size has been pretty fascinating to watch. Because I personally, in my own time, I'm a center console guy. You know, I've always had center consoles or walk-arounds in my personal life. So it, to me, it's very exciting to see. Because when I had a 35-footer, I thought I had made it in the center console world. And now I see there's a 53-footer across the bay. I think it's that way.
Yeah. A whole lot of engines.
It's a whole lot of engines, but it's really amazing to see. And, you know, let's put 10 people for dinner under the hardtop.
Yeah,
you know?
it's crazy to see, like, what they can put on the back of these boats now. I mean, it looks like they're almost Photoshop images sometimes when you see, you know, the back with the outboards of having five or even six sometimes on the back.
The first time I count, it's like 3,135 horsepower. I was like, wow. I mean, I crew on a 50-foot Sportfish up in the Northeast where I'm from. And that has a third less of the horsepower than that center console. And we cruise at 30 knots. So it's really, to me, that's really something that's been cool to see develop.
Is the
growth of that. And also the way that boat builders, and this boat is actually a pretty good example, to incorporate structural glass to offer better connection to people on board with the outside environment that they're cruising in. That's been pretty fascinating. And you see and more. And it's really effective at bringing the light in, as you can see with us here today, even on a rainy day.
Yes, a little bit rainy, but it'll be beautiful tomorrow.
So when you do stuff like that and you have these giant solar ceiling windows and then you cut down the bulwarks and then when you're cruising with your family, everybody has a great view. You know, as I like I said, in particular, I'm sitting on this boat, we're looking around right now, and you can see behind us, I mean, the height of this class. I mean, it's just a great cruising platform.
And I think a lot of it is, I mean, it's just bringing the outside indoors too. So if you are, you know, if you want to just be in the AC, just kind of relax, but you still want that feeling of being out on the water, which you already are anyway, but you just get that feeling of being outdoors while indoors.
I also think the growth of the foredeck as an entertainment space as opposed to a place where you do your, you know, ground tackle has been pretty fascinating to watch develop, and how far builders are taking that technology further and further. As I used to be, we'll put a sun pit there. I was like, we're gonna put these loungers. Now we're gonna put a table, and then we're gonna put this, and we're gonna put this over here. Maybe we'll put a pool over there. You know, so you're just getting to the point where they're really, the utilization of space on board is really hit a level I've never seen before, and I look forward to seeing what happens next.
Speaking of what happens next, what are you really looking forward to seeing? What are some of the other things that you're really looking forward to seeing in the future of boating?
Wow, that's such a big question. Huge question. I have such a little brain. You know, like I said, I didn't think structural glass would get to where it is. So I'd like to see how much further that can go. I'd like to see where this outboard thing is going to, where it's going to go. Another technology that I'm really fascinated about, I've now seen three companies starting to do it, is docking assist. Right? Docking assist technology.
We're excited for
that. So, you know, Volvo Penta had started developing one, Raymarine, and now Yanmar has announced it there. And they all work differently, but they're all achieving the same goal. So dock assist technology, you know, I've always was fascinated with cars, and they were, you know, with, and you know, you have all this assist. So it's pretty interesting to see how some of that technology starts off in auto is drifting into marine.
Definitely.
So dock assist technology is definitely one thing I want to keep my eye on.
And it brings people, you know, just like Seakeeper and gyro stabilization, it brings people that have been wanting to boat, but they might have an issue with something, like they get seasick or they are a little afraid of these larger boats and docking.
It brings them into it easier.
Anything that increases, you know, increases the pleasure of being on the water is going to keep people in the sport, right? So the more the technology allows you to do that, the better. I mean, What's funny is that there's always a hesitation at first. Mm-hmm. Like the first time I saw a boat that had a bow thruster, and it was coming in, I remember the captain was using a bow thruster to bring it in, and somebody on the dock said, "If you need a bow thruster, you shouldn't have a boat." And the captain brought it in. He goes, "If something can help me, I'm going to use it."
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, and I'm totally on board with that concept. That's you give me a bow and a stern thruster. Mm-hmm. I'm even happier.
Yeah.
You know, anything that makes the boating day more pleasurable, you know, and easier on the family and everybody's having a good time. Nobody's screaming and yelling about what's going on. Oh, grab this, grab that.
Everybody's had those moments, I'm sure.
Yeah, absolutely. I've had them. I'll admit it. I've said it. I'm Patrick. I'm a boater. I've made mistakes.
We all have. So by speaking of that, you're talking about some of the older technology. What was like the first thing that you, when you came into the industry and started riding and testing boats, the first thing that you did or saw that you were like, wow, that's different?
The first time I saw actually an electronic diesel, because when I first started to do fuel flow and stuff to test boats, we used to have to carry all these tools with us. And so I would have to go into an engine room, and we would have to break the fuel lines, and we'd have to put in the computer gear, and then we'd have to run all these lines up. Sure. And after it was done, we had to break everything down. And so a boat test didn't take 3 hours. A boat test took 10 hours.
Because
mm-hmm. Then you had to clean up.
And
then you went to the airport, you know, smelling like the inside of a fuel tank. So when the first electronic engines came out and we could actually have the readouts at the helm, it was like an aha moment, you know. Mm-hmm. It was a light bulb moment where it's like, oh my gosh, this is so cool.
Game changer.
It was a game changer. And now, you know, down to the smallest outboards, you have displays at the helm that give you all the information you need.
Yep.
Yeah, it's pretty fascinating.
Well, and if you guys have any questions or what are some of the future technologies that you guys are really excited to see, we would love to hear about that. And also, what are you guys, so when you come to a boat show like this, Your goal is to get on boats, right? Tell us a little bit about that. You know, what does that excite you when you get to a show? You're like, this is it. This is what I'm.
Oh yeah, no, absolutely. I don't even know how many shows I've been to over the years. I mean, if you take 19 years and figure 7 or 8 shows a year, whoever's good at math out there, do that. That's a lot of shows.
Yeah.
Right, but it never gets old. You know, it's like looking up at a great sky. I mean, it's just beautiful, right? So anytime you get to go, it's like experiencing new all over again, because there's always going to be new. I mean, the builders have just, you know, they're doing a lot of R&D. There's constantly new product coming out. There's actually more product coming out than we can even cover, which is like such a wonderful first world problem to have.
Sure.
And there's all these new ideas. The first time I saw fold out terraces, you know, and you thought that was only going to be a super yacht thing. And then they got it down at the small boat, and then they got into mid-sized cruisers, and these boats have them, you know. So that was like, that kind of stuff is just so cool. So being a sport fish guy in my free time, I'm always looking for the new sport fish launches.
Sure.
Whenever I can sneak away for a minute.
Yep.
And there's a bunch here that I'll hopefully maybe by Saturday I'll get some time to go check out.
Yep.
But I love to crawl around sport fish boats because I learn something new every time I get on one, and so to me personally that's fascinating. But just seeing all the new.
Okay,
oh, yeah.
Well, let's take a moment to check in with Abby. I think we have a question coming from behind the camera.
Okay, we've got a couple questions. First, we have Lisa H. that says she loves free stuff. So shout out to Lisa H. We'll make sure you get some free stuff, Lisa. All right. Second question we had come in from Michael L., and it goes back to your dock assist. Is there any dock assist that you've heard of that's being done with verbal communication?
Not that I've heard of yet.
Not yet.
Somebody who wants that idea, we'll sell it to you.
So what would the cue be? Don't hit the dock boat?
Is that kind of an Alexa? Hey Alexa,
park my boat.
Yeah.
That would be awesome.
Yeah, not too far off.
But so far, you know, systems are working off of, you know, cameras and sensors.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm really, like I said, I haven't had a chance to see it in action yet. So I'm really hoping this week we get to see that.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm surprised cameras too. I would think it was just, you know, be pinging all the different things around it, but actually using cameras to kind of have awareness of where you
are.
Well,
that's one system is using using cameras on the boat.
Okay.
Another system is using sensors and stuff on the dock. So it would be for your own slip, your home slip, whereas the camera system on the boat allows you to use any slip, right? So those are the differences in the technologies.
At some point, you're going to just be like, take me to Siesta Key or somewhere and just press
a button.
Well,
I think it's
going to
be like
right?
the question, right? You're just going to tell your boat, go ahead.
take me to this restaurant.
It'll be the debate between people who want to drive versus the people who just want to hang out and relax. Well, cars, not right.
We'll get artificial intelligence next, and we'll just say boat conch salad, and it goes to Bimini, right? It'll just know.
That's on the horizon, I'm sure.
Yes. Okay. While we're waiting to figure that out, Caleb P. would like to know, are you looking for another personal boat? You have a 35, how about a 38?
Which 38?
Good question, Caleb.
Yeah. You're always looking for that next boat, even when you just get your new boat.
That's true.
You always got to be looking ahead. So I think we're coming up on our time, so just tell us, you know, where can people find you throughout the show? Where can they find Yachting Magazine online? What they should they be watching?
You can go to yachtingmagazine.com is our website. Yachting Magazine on Facebook, Yachting Mag on Twitter, and Yachting Magazine on Instagram. And we'll be all through the show. We'll be putting up content all throughout the show.
Yes. So make sure if you're at the show, keep an eye out for Patrick. Give him a wave. Say hello.
And sure, they'll be wearing these Yachting Magazine shirts. And if you see us, MarineMax team, we'll be wearing our MarineMax swag all weekend long. And we're really excited. This is the beginning.
Mm-hmm. A lot of great stuff coming.
A lot of sunshine coming too.
Follow along for MarineMax on our Facebook pages, Instagram, Twitter. There'll be stuff coming up on YouTube.
Yep.
You can also go to marinemax.com/Miami Boat Show to get details about the show. And of course, we have lots of live content coming up. So stay tuned. Follow again the Facebook pages. And on Friday, we'll be doing another live with Seakeeper. So that'll be some interesting technology to hear about as well.
Definitely. Yeah. And again, just check out all of our social media channels. We'll be posting stuff all weekend long. And if you guys want to see anything in particular, please reach out, send your comments, and we'll be showing you what you want to see.
And one final reminder, someone said, and where again is the new yacht show?
It is in downtown Miami.
Don't go to Collins. Like pen drop.
Done. Okay, well, thank you everyone for joining us. Thank you, Patrick.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you very much. This was awesome. We appreciate it. Okay. And we'll see you next time.